Oh, hi, I'm Jearl Walker. I'm one of the physics professors here at Cleveland State University. And today, I'm going to show you how I can calculate the speed of light using cheese in a microwave oven. Now, normally when you heat up food in a microwave oven, you want to rotate the food because there are going to be hot spots in the oven. And you want to rotate your food through the hot spots to kind of uniformly heat the food. I'm going to defeat that rotation by turning this tray upside down, because I want to see the hot spots. The hot spots in this layer of cheese that I've put on a piece of plastic. I'm going to put this inside. Now, what's going to happen when I turn on the oven? Microwaves, form of light, are going to go left and right and front and back. The waves are going to travel through each other. In some places, they're going to reinforce each other, and that's going to give me a hot spot there. Some places are going to cancel each other, and it's not going to be a hot spot there. The reason that I get hot spots is because the microwaves interfere with the bonding between water molecules. It breaks the bonds, and that puts in thermal energy. And once that water gets hot, it heats up the surrounding food material. So in a microwave oven, you're really just heating up primarily the water content in the food. Here for the cheese, I'm going to shut this up. It'll take about a minute, and we'll see what happens. And we got hot spots right here, right here, right there. And I want to measure the distance between them. Here's, I'm going to do those right there. And I'm going to say that's about 7.5 centimeters between the hot spots. That's half the wavelength of the light. So the light wavelength, the microwave wavelength, is going to be about 15 centimeters. Let me use that in a calculation. Here's an equation that works for any kind of wave, including microwaves, the form of light that we're using. If I want the speed of the wave, I multiply the frequency of the wave by the wavelength. Now, I went to the manufacturer's website to get the frequency, and it is 2.45 times 10 to the 9 hertz, or times per second. And we just got through measuring the wavelength of the microwaves as being 0.15 meters. I multiply these two numbers, and I get, for the speed of the wave, the speed of light, 3.7 times 10 to the 8th meters per second. Well, that's real close to the accepted value of 3.0 times 10 to the 8th. So with just the cheese, I'm really, really close. Well, there you have it. Not only do I have the speed of light, but I've also got my lunch for today. Well, thanks for watching. Hope to see you again here at the Flying Circus of Physics. Just remember, physics is everywhere, even in slices of cheese.